Hello everyone out there, my fellow math contest enthusiasts. Root Beer here, and I'm going to be going through another University of Waterloo Galois paper. This time it's going to be from the year 2015. So if you'd like a copy for yourself to practice, try out, maybe race a friend or a loved one, you can get a copy by clicking the very first link in the description. It looks a little something like this. Okay. There's our paper. It is the 2015 one. Remember, the Galois is part of the Friar Galois and Hypatia papers. The Galois is the grade 10 level. So if you want something a little easier, that'd be the Friar for grade 9 and the Hypatia for grade 11. So a couple quick things to note. Calculators are absolutely allowed on the paper. I've got mine ready in case I need it. You don't want to forget your calculator the day of the actual contest. There's four questions. They're all worth the same amount, so you probably want to go 1, 2, 3, 4 in that order because the questions do get harder as you go along. If you're going to practice, give yourself 75 minutes. You know, put out an egg timer or on your cell phone or whatever it is. Give yourself an hour 15 and try it out. So like all of Waterloo's written contests, there are short answer questions indicated by the light bulb, and then there are show all your work questions indicated by the pen to paper. So in this video, we're just going to go through question number one, and then next time question two, and so on until we're done the contest. All right, so question number one here is one light bulb and two written parts. A, in the diagram, line one has equation y equals 2x plus 6, so that's this line here, and crosses the x-axis at P. What is the x-intercept of line one? So what are the coordinates of P is basically what they're asking. Okay, well, you get the x-intercept when y is equal to 0. So we'll let 0 equal, it was 2x plus 6, I believe. I'll just double check before I go any further. Yes, 2x plus 6. So now we just rearrange, bring the 6 over to the other side, divide both sides by 2. And x is negative 3. So you could say something like p is at negative 3, 0, or you could say the x-intercept is negative 3. But it is a light bulb question, so all that really matters is that minus 3. If you write the x-intercept is minus 3, you'll get 2 out of 2 or 3 out of 3 or whatever this is worth. But if we're wrong, say we wrote down 3 and not minus 3. So if we wrote down 3 and our answer was wrong, but then they go back, they'll check your work on a light bulb question if your answer is wrong. If your answer is right, you get full marks. But if it's wrong, they will check to see if you've written anything and what you've written. So we can get part marks by, you know, scribbling something in. And that can sometimes save you if you're rushing a little bit or if you haven't fully understood the question. Showing your work can certainly help sometimes on a light bulb. But it's not required. It's not required at all. So I know some people who are trying to go really fast, give themselves enough time for question four, they will just write their final answers for the light bulbs. They won't show any work. Usually in the booklet, I'll just do my rough work where the light bulb is and then put my final answer. And I won't clean up my rough work at all. Anyway, let's move on to B part. Line 2 over here has slope negative 3 and intersects line 1 at 3, 12. Determine the equation of line 2. So I know the slope is negative 3, and Q, which is at 3, 12, is on the line. All you need is a point and a slope. And now they're asking for the equation. There are lots of equations you could do. For example, if you wanted to use what's called point-slope form of the line, you could just write something like this. You take the 3, the x-coordinate, and the y-coordinate, subtract them from x and y respectively, and multiply the x stuff by the negative 3. This is called point-slope form of the line. It's perfectly fine. It's not commonly taught, I found, in high school these days. So I'm going to do y equals mx plus b form, similar to the form of the line they have for line 1 in part A. And I'm matching the information they gave me. And this seems nice, I guess. So, okay, so we know the slope is minus 3. So we'll say y equals negative 3x plus b. But 3, 12 is on this line, so 12 is negative 3 times 3 plus b. That's negative 9 plus b. Move the 9 over to the other side. 12 plus 9 is 21. So 21 is b. So, our final answer is going to be y is negative 3x plus 21. Now, this is a written question, so we do actually need to show our work, but, I mean, what I've got here is perfectly fine. You don't have to, I mean, all I've done is show my calculations. You'll notice I'm not really writing in complete sentences. That is not required. All that is required is that it's clear to the markers what I'm doing, everything's justified, and that I keep myself organized. I've got my answer. I put a box around it to indicate, hey, look at this. It's done. Mark this, please. Okay. That's all we need to do. So now we've got line two. If you want to, there's no harm in putting therefore statements and writing in full sentences. I find it takes a lot of time. Line two crosses the x-axis at r, as shown. Determine the area of triangle PQR. So I can see the height is going to be 12 for this triangle. Now let's draw a copy of this in our notebook. So we have R here, P here, and we already know from earlier that the x-intercept is minus 3, so P is at minus 3, 0. We got 3, 12 here. So I have a height of 12, which I will just clearly indicate on the diagram. And then if I could figure out what R is, so I'm going to say let's find the coordinates of R, making it very clear what I'm about to do. R is the x-intercept, as they said, and as we already saw in part A, you just let the y-coordinate be 0. So minus 3 plus 21. So 3x is 21 divided by 3x is 7. So R is at 7, 0. Now I'll add that in down here. And so now this base, the distance PR, is going to be 7 minus negative 3, and that's 10. So I would probably say that PR is 10. You could even show the calculation 7 minus negative 3, but I think that's fine. So PR is 10, and I would say the height is 12. You could even say as shown. But now the area, let's just calculate that. So we've got a base of 10 and a height of 12. So this is 1 half, 120. So the area of this triangle is 60. And if you want to, you can say, therefore, the area of triangle PQR is 60. They don't have units, so we don't need units. But there we go. We've explained ourselves. You could say, you know, from B, just to explain where you got the line from. But I think it's going to be clear to whoever's marking. And that's all you need to do. A nice, clearly labeled picture, a little bit of calculation, and we're done. Okay. So that's question number one. Up next, we're going to take a look at question number two, and then question three, and so on, as I've already said. So if you'd like to see question two on our 2015 Galois, please join me next time. See you around.